This is an era of lenses. Webcams, CCTVs, and hidden pinhole cameras all around us. Instant close-ups of live events from various angles beamed around the world with instant replay available. More film and video and photos on demand than could be seen in 100 lifetimes. And the simple fact that no self-respecting girls' night out on the town is complete without numerous photos taken on many a mobile phone held up at arm's length, with the lens pointing back down the length of that arm towards her who holds it aloft, ready for upload into global visibility on social media the next day when the effect of the cocktails has worn off, or even instant global visibility there and then, through upload from that mobile between cocktails number 3 and 4. Is this proliferation of all these glass lenses unnatural in some essential way? Probably. Is it contributing to our headlong rush away from the red-blooded, rain-soaked, face-to-face physicality of land and animals and crops and weather that we once inhabited, our retreat from the real space of town squares and marketplaces, our ever more artificial and complex ascent out of the concrete and analogue into the digital and mediated? You bet. And is that fun? Hell yeah! One of this book's missions, as I discovered while making it, is the extension of that proliferation of glass lenses into the traditionally lensless arena of literary text. Since this book contained a certain amount of self-portraiture, for which there is an established tradition using just words by themselves, my pushing of lenses into the substance of literary prose resulted in a matching amount of photographic self-portraiture to echo the written element. For although all characters draw mostly on pure invention and sometimes on real people, all the 7 major characters, Jamie, Aliyah, Evelyn, Shigem, Kim, Angel and Pippa, do draw on aspects of me. The photographic result of this, mixed with the rest of the cast, is a depiction by me of the narrated Jamie, rather than a depiction of me as myself, however, because the photographs in the book are stills from the 12 films, where I'm cast as him. Literary fiction has usually been a series of rectangular chunks of typeface assembled in an order that acts as a complex lens through which a two-way journey happens. Readers look into the mind of the writer, and the writer looks out into the world and shines onto it some of the colours of his or her mind. And visual artists in most eras have often made self-portraits of one kind or another in an attempt to understand more about what being alive means and looks like and feels like, and just what it is, this being alive business that we were all thrown into with such a rude lack of consultation ahead of time. Especially in its electronic versions, this book therefore combines those two venerable presentation formats, literary fiction and self-portraiture, with elements of the newer, more multitudinous formats of self-presentation and self-iconization that occur online. In this, a series of 10 further kinds of lens have been involved. Number one, most concretely, there are the glass lenses in the devices that recorded and conveyed the images of Jen, Mel, Alexis, Credo, Nadia, Paula, Matthew and me. An HDV video camera, a Super 8 film camera, and the projector and camera in the telecine setup. Number two, least concretely, located somewhere among or between the words, there are the 7 lenses constituted by the 7 major characters, Jamie, Aliyah, Evelyn, Shigem, Kim, Angel and Pippa, in the sense that each of these is a lens onto the world, possessing her or his own distinctive optical properties and tint of glass. And number three, as suggested by the presence of the 9 names, Jamie, Aliyah, Evelyn, Mark, Kim, Shigem, Pippa, Angel and Damien, within the names of the 12 films, there are the 12 lenses that these films point into those 9 characters. Because our imagination thief narrator Jamie Peake is quite often peeking into the imagination of one or other person around him, and occasionally into the imaginations of 2 other people simultaneously, seeing, among other things, how they look at themselves and at one another and at him, he adds to the above list number 4, the lens of his own special sight. Positioned in front of 3 camera lenses, numbers 5, 6 and 7, he also spends the tidy figure of 10 sessions projecting different things out of his eyes, numbers 8 and 9. One session projecting a huge live broadcast of material from his own mind. 3 sessions projecting material for a huge pre-recorded broadcast of his own mind. And 6 secret sessions projecting material he's thieved from other people's minds. This projection process is depicted with greatest simplicity in the films Jamie 54, Jamie 115, and Angel 22, but all 12 films show it in their different ways. The self-portraiture element of the book demanded that I assume the same position Jamie does, i.e. in front of, number 10, an unblinking HDV camera lens, performing at this lens for the tidy figure of 10 hours in total, so as to project all 10 parts of the book. This I did, and this was the process that created the 10-hour video book version of The Imagination Thief, which is embedded live inside this ebook, alongside and in sync with the very first kind of lens I mentioned above, that series of rectangular chunks of typeface assembled in an order that still acts as the most complex and analogue lens of all. The films and their stills are also embedded in the ebook, alongside the typeface version and the video book, forming an extension from those two formats. These three formats, text, video book, and films, echo those three lenses, numbers 5, 6, and 7, pointing at Jamie in his hidden TV studio in the ruins of the Metropolitan Hotel, each of them positioned at 45 degrees from the one beside it, in the sense that all three are aimed at the same target. Three styles of portrait are thereby made, from each of which Jamie gazes out of the ebook and this website, straight into your and my imaginations. One key to the maze under The Imagination Thief is to be found in the beauty of plane crashes. I mean those rare plane crashes where everyone escapes unhurt. I'm thinking here of the crash landings of its characters into the rock slopes of the hillside upstairs from the labyrinth, which is where they landed in that world. Just as for us flesh and blood cousins of them out here in the real world, it was hardly comfortable for those characters to have landed and survived in that world there, but the walking plane crashes of their advent into that life are nonetheless as beautiful as ours here. Like many self-portraits, the picture of Jamie Peake's self in The Imagination Thief contains elements of everyone, which may be why his personality is somewhat elusive. He's a mixture of truth and lies, adding up to a fiction, through which I suspect I'm wondering aloud what it is to be alive as a human being in a body on this particular planet these days. At least, that's my best guess at what I'm wondering aloud through him. I'm not 100% certain of it. Whatever the question is, perhaps it'll become clearer in the course of finishing the London and Dubai novels. Or perhaps these two will prefer to show me the lovely confusion of a different proliferation of lenses, of other coloured smoke, and further mirrors.